Hello children, this is for 7th standard science, biology lesson, basis of classification, part 2, in page number 78. So last class you have seen about animals classification. This class we are going to see about classification of plants. Okay children, so based on dichotomy, plants also can be classified into two main groups, flowering and non-flowering. Flowering means the plants which will give flower. Non-flowering means the plants which is not giving flower. Okay children, so non-flowering plants do not produce seeds and flowering plants produce seeds. Okay, so you know seeds will be produced by flower, isn't it? Flower only will give seed. Yes children, so non-flowering plants do not produce seeds. Why? Means it's not having any flower, and flowering plants produce seeds. So based on their nature of plant body, non-flowering plants are classified into three types: algae, mosses and ferns. Okay, based on their fruit body, flowering plants are classified into two types, gymnosperms and angiosperms. Okay children, so you can see this classification, this diagram is, so plants it is classified into two main groups, which do not produce seed and produce seeds. So coming to do not produce seed, it is having, the plants is having roots, stems and leaves, example ferns, and the plants which is not having any true roots, stems or leaves, example algae, and which is not producing seed has some mosses will be the example for this, that is which is having some roots, stems, leaves and leaves like structures. So coming to produce seeds plants, it is again classified into two types, non-flowering plants and flowering plants. Non-flowering plants, example gymnosperms, conifers. Flowering plants, angiosperms. And angiosperms again divided into two main category, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Monocotyledon means which is having only one cotyledon. Dicotyledon means which is having two cotyledons. Let us see one by one. First we will see about algae. So algae plant is thallus, not well differentiated into root, stem and leaves. So algae is a plant. Usually the plant will have root system, shoot system, flower, isn't it? Is fruit like that, leaves, and some plants fruits may be appearing at the top of the plant and root may be appearing on the shoot. Is like that, but this algae plant is thallus, that is it's not well differentiated into root, stem and leaves. So they are predominantly aquatic. Aqua means water. Aquatic means the plants will be growing only in water. They are unicellular or multicellular or filamentous. You know, unicellular means plants which is having only one cell. Multicellular means more than one cell. Filamentous means filament like hair like structure will be present. Example, cara. Okay children, next we will see. You can see this picture. Yes, the next one, mosses. So plant body is not differentiated into true root, stem and leaves. They are water living plants, needs moisture to complete its life cycle. So this mosses is also, it's a living plant, water living plant, needs moisture. Moisture means irapadam. Yes, needs moisture to complete its life cycle. Hence they are referred to as amphibious plants. Amphibians means what? Animals which can live both on land and in water. Like that, this mosses plant is also water living plant and it also needs moisture to complete its life cycle. They do not have any specialized vascular tissues for conduction of water and food. Usually, plants will have tubular structure, vascular tubular structure. For what purpose? Means for the conduction of water from the root to each and every part of a plant. Okay, but this mosses is not having specialized vascular tissues for conduction of water and food. Example, Funaria. The next one is ferns. Plant body is well differentiated into root, stem and leaves. So algae and mosses, it is not well differentiated into true root shoot like that, but ferns is a plant body well differentiated into root, stem and leaves. Leaves may be large or small. So specialized vascular tissues are found for the conduction of water and food. Basically, they are the first land plants which grows well in shady, moist and cool places. Example, Adiantum. Okay children, next we will see the next classification, Gymnosperms. So plants are perennial, woody, evergreen with true root, stem and leaves, and they possess vascular tissues, xylem without vessels and phloem without companion cells, and ovules are naked without ovary. Okay, ovules is not having ovary. Okay, then hence they do not produce fruits, seeds are naked. Example, Pinus cycas. Then Angiosperms, plant body is well differentiated into true root, stem and leaves. They produce flower with four whorls, calyx, corolla, androecium and gynoecium. We have seen in hibiscus flower, right? So like that. Hence they are known as flowering plants. Female reproductive organ, ovaries present inside the flower, which develops into fruit, and ovule develops into seed. Plant possesses well developed vascular system with xylem vessels and phloem companion cells. Then coming to Angiosperms, are the dominant plant forms of present day. Based on the number of cotyledons, again Angiosperms are broadly classified into two groups, monocotyledons and dicotyledons. Plant seeds which have only one cotyledon are said to be monocots. So if you take rice, you cannot divide it into two equal halves, isn't it? Yes, so we call that seed as monocotyledon. Plant seeds which have two cotyledons are known as dicots. Example, tamarind. So you can see this picture, that will be helpful for you to understand. So if you take the paddy seed, it is having only one cotyledon. That cotyledon is developed into a plant. So tamarind, if you see that seed, you can divide it into two equal halves. Okay children, the next one, the five kingdom classification. So the five kingdom classification was first proposed by R.H. Whittaker in 1969. In which year? In 1969. So five kingdoms were formed on the basis of characteristics such as cell structure, mode of nutrition. Nutrition means food, whether it is autotrophic or heterotrophic. We will say no. Autotrophic means which can produce food for themselves. We call that as autotrophs. Heterotrophs means which cannot produce food, which will depend on other organisms for getting food. Okay children, so that is the mode of nutrition and source of nutrition. In what way they are producing the food, and also the body organization. Body organization means the structure of the body. Okay children, so there are five kingdoms. We'll see one by one. First one is Kingdom Monera. Yes, Kingdom Monera. Best example is bacteria. So all prokaryotes belong to the Kingdom Monera, which do not possess true nucleus. Already we have seen the word prokaryotic and eukaryotic cell. Prokaryotic cell means which is not having nucleus. So it's not having nucleus means it is not having any nuclear membrane. Okay children, so cells of prokaryotes do not have a nuclear membrane or any other membrane bound organelles. Okay, so most of the bacteria are heterotrophic, but some are autotrophs. So bacteria and blue green algae are examples for Monera. So if you see this picture, so five kingdom of classification is, first one we'll see bacteria. It's given bacteria, fungi, plants, animals and protista. We'll see one by one. Okay, children. So next one, we'll see kingdom protista. So the kingdom protista includes unicellular and a few simple multicellular eukaryotes. Okay, unicellular means which is having only one cell. Multicellular means which is having more cells. Yes, and also few simple multicellular eukaryotes. Eukaryotes means which is having nucleus. Prokaryotes means which is not having nucleus. So kingdom protista will have unicellular organisms and also few simple multicellular organisms which is having nucleus. Clear, children? So there are two main groups of protists. The plant-like protists are photosynthetic and commonly called algae. Okay, so algae, already we have seen algae and mosses, we have seen ferns, isn't it? So here there are two main groups of protists. The plant protists or photosynthetic. Photosynthetic means it can produce its own food by the process of photosynthesis. Okay, children, example algae. So algae include unicellular and multicellular types. Animals like protists are often called protozoans. Okay, so they include amoeba and paramecium. Example for protista family means amoeba and paramecium. Next one, kingdom fungi. So fungi are eukaryotic. Eukaryotic means which is having nucleus and mostly are multicellular. So they secrete enzymes to digest the food and absorb the food after digested by the enzymes. So fungi saprophytes as decomposers. The decay means causing organisms, or as parasites. Parasites means depend on other organisms. It will develop only if it touches, if it grows on another organism. Okay, children? So we call that as parasites. So kingdom fungi includes molds, mildews, mushrooms and yeast. The next one, kingdom plantae. Plantae are multicellular eukaryotes that carry out photosynthesis. Reserve food materials are starch and lipids in the form of oil or fat. Plant cells have cell wall and specialized functions such as photosynthesis, transport of materials and support. And kingdom plantae includes ferns, cone-bearing plants and flowering plants. Okay, children, then last one is kingdom animalia. Animalia means animals which are multicellular, eukaryotic and heterotrophic animals. Animals cannot produce their own food, isn't it? It will depend on other organisms for getting food. So cells have no cell wall. Only plant cell will have cell wall. Animal cell will not have cell wall. So here animalia, animals, they are having cells, yes, and with nucleus, but it's not having cell wall. Most members of the animal kingdom can move from one place to another place. Example, invertebrates like sponges, hydra, flatworms, roundworms, insects, snails, starfishes, and vertebrates like fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals, including human beings, belong to the kingdom Animalia. Okay, children, so here the picture is given. Yes. Frog, amphibian, reptile, crocodile, mammals, cow, bird, owls. So the next thing, this table is very, very, very important. 5-mark question. If you read this one, that will be helpful when you are going to higher classes. So important characteristics of five kingdoms. So kingdom name it is given is Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. So cell type, whether it is unicellular or multicellular, prokaryotic or eukaryotic. Okay, children. So Monera, it is having unicellular prokaryotic, protista unicellular eukaryotic, fungi multicellular non-green and eukaryotic, plantae multicellular and eukaryotic, animals multicellular and eukaryotic. Nucleus. Prokaryotic means nucleus absent. Eukaryotic means nucleus present. Okay. So nucleus is absent in Monera. The other four things, nucleus is present. Then third one, body organization. Cellular level of organization is, whether it is unicellular or multicellular, it is given. protista, cellular level of organization, fungi, multicellular with loose tissue, plant A, tissue level and organ level, and animals, tissue, organ and organ system, like human beings. The next one, mode of nutrition, autotrophic means it can produce its own food. Heterotrophic means depend on other organisms. So Monera, either auto or heterotrophic. Protista also auto or heterotrophic. Fungi, saprophytic, parasitic. Plant A, autotrophic. Animals, heterotrophic. On each and everything, example is given. Monera, bacteria and blue-green algae. Protista, Spirogyra and Chlamydomonas. Fungi, Rhizopus and Agaricus. Plant A, herb, shrub and trees. Animalia, fish, frog, crocodile, birds and human being. Okay, children. So when everything is invented or ruled or anything is discovered, there may be a merits and demerits. We'll see this merits and demerits of kingdom classification. Merits of five kingdom classification. The system of classification is more scientific and natural. The system of classification clearly indicates the cellular organization, mode of nutrition and characters for early evolution of life. It is giving everything. It is the main most accepted system of modern classification, as the different groups of organisms are placed phylogenetically. It indicates gradual evolution of complex organism from simpler one. So these are all four merits of kingdom classification. Demerits of five kingdom classification. In this system of classification, virus have not been given a proper place. Multicellular organisms have originated several times from protista. This type of classification has drawn back with reference to the lower forms of life, and some organisms included under protista are not eukaryotic. Okay, children, next we'll see binomial nomenclature. Nominal means name. Binominal means two names. Okay, Gaspard Bauhin in 1623 introduced naming of organisms with two names, which is known as binomial nomenclature. And it was implemented by Carolus Linnaeus in 1753. So only he is known as father of modern taxonomy. So we'll see first what is binomial nomenclature. Binomial nomenclature is an universal system of naming organisms. So as per this system, each organisms have two names. The first is the genus name and second is the species name. Okay, children, genus name begins with capital letter and species name begins with a small letter. So for each and every organisms, instead of calling one name, it will have two names. For example, for hibiscus flower, ordinary name what we are telling is hibiscus. Okay, children, binomial name means Hibiscus rosa sinensis. So this first one, hibiscus, is genus. Rosa sinensis is species. So hibiscus should start with the capital letter. Rosa sinensis R should be in a small letter. Clear, children? So vernacular name is a local name that is familiar for a particular place. So example it is given. The nomenclature for onion is Allium sativum. So here genus name is Allium, species name is sativum. So vernacular name is a local name that is familiar for a particular place. Binomial name is an universal name which never changes. Okay, so binomial nomenclature and classification help scientists to identify the organisms and to place them at a particular hierarchy. Okay, children, so here some 15 names are given. Binomial name, common name and scientific name. Okay, so another name for binomial nomenclature is scientific name. So common name for human being, scientific name for human being is Homo sapiens, onion, Alivum sativum, rat, Rattus rattus, pigeon, Columba livia, tamarind, Tamarindus indica, lime, citrus aurantifolia, neem tree, azadiaca indica, frog, rana hexadactyla, coconut, cocos nucifera, paddy, oryza sativa, fish, catla catla, orange, citrus sinensis, ginger, zingiber officinale, papaya, carica papaya, date, phoenix, dactylifera. So you can read the names which is asked only in the evaluation part. That is enough. Okay children, let us conclude this lesson by seeing points to remember. So what is classification? Classification of living organism is made on the basis of their characteristics, similarities and differences. Classification is needful to identify living organisms and to study about them conveniently. So kingdom is the largest division of the living world and species is the basic unit of classification. So kingdom Animalia is divided into two subkingdoms, invertebrates, that is animals without backbone, vertebrates, animals with backbone. Invertebrates are classified into 9 phyla and vertebrates are classified into 5 classes. Coming to plants, plants are classified into flowering and non-flowering plants and further classified into groups based on the nature of plant body and fruiting body. In 1969, R.H. Whittaker proposed a 5 kingdom of classification of living organisms. So what are they? The 5 kingdom classification includes Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Gaspard Bauhin in 1623 introduced the binomial nomenclature and it was implemented by Carolus Linnaeus in 1753. So binomial nomenclature is an universal system of naming organisms. It contains two names. The first name of the binomial is genus name and the second name is species name. Carolus Linnaeus is known as the father of modern taxonomy. I hope you understand this lesson. It is a very easy lesson, but if it is very important lesson, if you read this lesson carefully, it will be helpful in higher classes. Okay, children, thank you.